its orbit, and now the day came, it changed. قال لا أحب الآفلين. إبراهيم عليه السلام said, I do not like things that are subject to change. In other words, I do not worship things that are subject to change, because change is a creation of Allah. Change is not the creator. Change itself is a creation, and the creation does not subjugate the creator. Change does not subjugate the creator. Allah subjugates change and subjugates everything else other than change. فَلَمَّا شَمْسْ now, they said, okay, the moon, okay, fine. Let's see the sun. شَمْسْ بَازِغَ big. هَذَا أَكْبَر قَالَ هَذَا أَكْبَر this is bigger than the moon, okay. The moon was not, now you start worshipping the sun. هَذَا رَبِّي فَلَمَّا أَفَلَتْ when also the sun left, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ all the way to the end of the ayah where he told them, oh people, then I cannot worship what you are worshipping. What you are worshipping is things that you have conceived in your minds, which is contrary to the truth. Allah جل جلاله cannot be conceived in the mind. Why? Because since our intellectual capacity is limited. Am I saying that? No. Number one, we are limited by what we know. We are limited by what we know. What you know now, you probably did not know 10 years ago. So 10 years ago, you were limited at that time. So we are limited by what we know. But what we know is limited. It is not that Allah did not give you the intellectual capacity. He did. Give you the intellectual capacity to understand things in your environment and things that have to do with you. And he gave you the intellectual capacity to realize that he is the one who is worthy of being worshipped. And no one else but him is worthy of being worshipped. But you have no intellectual capacity to encompass the Creator or know him on a way that is encompassing subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because you have a limited intellectual capacity. When it comes to that, not that it is degrading in the sense of being the creation. No, you have been created في أحسن تقويم. But define infinity. How can you define these things? So sometimes you stand incapacitated of defining a creation. Define black holes. They talk about in the spaces. What I'm trying to say, dear brothers and sisters, is sometimes because there are all kinds of things that seep into the faith of the believers, we have to understand and go back to Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. Allahu Ahad means the unique, the absolute unique, that nothing is like him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allahu Samad. The one who is not in need of anything, yet everything is in need of him. He's not in need of a place, not in need of a space, not in need of time, not in need of you, not in need of our worship, not in need of anything, yet everything is in need of him. He is not in need of the creation, but the creation is in need of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to exist. هذا الغني المطلق جل جلاله. This is the absolute غني سبحانه وتعالى. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Again the ayah comes back. لم يكن له كفوا أحد. الكفء is a ند in the Arabic language أو المثل which means the similar. كفوا means similar. No one is similar to him سبحانه وتعالى. No one is similar to him. That's why you see Tahawi rahimahullah when he mentions in his text in the Aqidah, he says قَدِيمٌ بِلَا ابْتِدَاءٍ eternal with no beginning. Eternal with no beginning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قَدِيمٌ. What does that mean? It means his existence is not limited by a beginning, is not limited by a time, because he is the creator of time and the creator of all beginnings. Beginnings are only a creation of Allah. And the creation does not subject the creator subjects all the creations. Eternal without a beginning, everlasting, قديم بلا ابتداء, دائم بلا انتهاء, everlasting with no end. Because ends are also creations of Allah. And beginnings and ends are what? Measurement of time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of time. He existed subhanahu wa ta'ala before time was created. Before the sun and the moon were created. Before the galaxies were created. Not before in the sense of a time frame. No. Before in the sense that nothing was created but Allah. Nothing was created. And the only creator was and is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was no creation. Hadith al-Bukhari narrated three times in three different versions. Al-Bukhari narrated. And Nabi al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَانَ اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ غَيْرُهُ. Allah existed when nothing else existed. What does that mean, nothing else? It means no space. Yes. No galaxies. Yes. No time. Yes. No skies. Yes. No earth. Yes. No stars. Nothing. 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 Nothing but Allah جل جلاله. Allah willed for the creation to appear at certain times. That's in His eternal will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدٍ. Nothing is similar to Him. Yet He is close to us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. A closeness that's not measured by distance, by physical distance, but He is closer to the one than His jugular vein. A closeness that is not measured by meters. But it is known by Allah's power and ilm and will and knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is with you wherever you go with His knowledge and will and power. But Allah has nothing like Him. He's not a mass that is occupied by place. Those of you who are physicists, you know the definition in physics of matter. Matter is a mass that occupies space. Mass is a creation of Allah. And space is a creation of Allah. And matter is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah is nothing like Him, Jalla Jalaluhu. Because sometimes all these things that seep into the peoples when they put cartoons now and they put these things. Because some people worship Superman. Superman, they worship Superman. What does that mean? Well, they worship an old man who has qualities of Superman. They call this whatever they want. You worship Al-Hayyu Al-Qayyum. الذي لا يزول سبحانه وتعالى. That's not subject to change. الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الرحمن الرحيم الجبار المتكبر السلام المؤمن المهيمن. Not a superman. Not a man like with superman qualities. لا. Allah is the creator of that man and the superman. I'm talking about this because of the importance of these things. Some other time we'll talk a little bit more about it. But we have to understand that when we talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we mean the creator, the God, the one